Good morning, children. Today I am going to start a new lesson, that is matter in our surroundings. Okay, by looking at the name matter in our surroundings, we should know about the matter. Matter means anything which occupies some space and has mass is called as a matter. You can consider a chalk piece. It is considered as a matter. How? It is occupying some space. Place is occupying and it has some mass. So, as it is occupying some space and has mass, it is considered as a matter. You can consider anything that comes under matter. Even air, sugar, sand, these are all comes under matter. Even your book is a matter. Okay. Classification of matter on the basis of physical properties. Generally, you all know the matter can be divided into three categories: solid, liquid, and gas. Now, what is the difference between solid, liquid, and gases? Okay. Now, before going to that, now if you take any matter, in between the particles of matter, in between the particles of matter, some attractions are present, some intermolecular forces or some attractive forces are present. Which will be there? What will be there? Some intermolecular forces or some attractive forces are there. And in between the particles of matter, some space also present. Small gaps are also present. They are called as intermolecular spaces. In between the particles of matter, some gaps, some space is there. That is called intermolecular spaces. And in between the particles of matter, some attractions are also present. They are called as intermolecular forces. So, now, what type of intermolecular forces, whether they are strong intermolecular forces or weak intermolecular forces, whether they have less intermolecular spaces or more intermolecular spaces, that all we will see now. Right? Now, the basic differences between solids, liquids and gases I am going to explain. If you consider the shape, solids have fixed shape. And when you consider the liquids, do not have fixed shape, no fixed shape. Gases have also no fixed shape. Now when you look at the volume, solids have fixed volume, liquids do not have fixed volume. The volume of the liquid is not fixed volume. The shape of the liquid is nothing but the shape of the container. That's what I said here, the liquids do not have fixed shape. And liquids do not have fixed shape and fixed volume. The liquids do not have fixed shape, but they have fixed volume. Liquids have fixed volume. And when you look at the gases, gases have no fixed shape and no fixed volume. The shape of the gas is nothing but the shape of the container which is present. Right? Now when you look at the rigidity, solids are rigid. Now the reasons I will tell you, let's observe carefully. Solids are rigid. That means cannot flow. Solids cannot flow. Cannot flow, flow means move. Solids cannot move. And liquids can flow. Liquids can flow, can move. So liquids are called fluids. Gases can flow. Gases can flow. So gases are also called fluids. Why solids are rigid means the intermolecular forces, in between the particles, strong intermolecular forces are present. In solids, in between the particles, strong intermolecular forces are present. In liquids, the intermolecular forces are less than the solids are present. In case of gases, the intermolecular forces are very, very less intermolecular forces. Very less intermolecular forces are present. And intermolecular space, if you take intermolecular spaces in solids, the particles are side by side, very less space is present.
very less space. The intermolecular spaces are very less in case of solids, and in liquids the intermolecular forces are intermolecular spaces are more than solids, right? And less than gases. And in case of gases, the intermolecular spaces are maximum. That's what the gas particles move away from each other. Compressibility. Solids cannot be compressible. That means compressibility on solid is negligible. Solids cannot be compressed. Liquids little compressible. Liquids are little compressible. But gases are highly compressible. Gases are highly compressible. These are the basic differences between solids and liquids and gases.
Yes, children. Now, to understand in between the particles of matter, some spaces are present. For that, we can do some activities. Just you observe what is going to happen here. Now, I am going to add potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate is a solid. Potassium permanganate I am going to add. Just observe what is going to happen. Now, with this activity we can understand the concept of diffusion also. Okay? Now, slowly I am dissolving. What happens is the total solution is going to get the pink color. Yes, you can understand here. What is going to happen? In the water molecules, in between the water molecules or in between the particles of water, some spaces are present. When I added potassium permanganate, these particles are went into the spaces. Here, this is nothing but it is an example of diffusion. The particles of a substance mixing on their own is called as a diffusion. Here, because of the diffusion, the particles are dissolved in this water. Right? One more activity you observe carefully. Here, I am adding the Dettol solution. Here also you can understand. Here also diffusion. Check, observe carefully. Just one or two drops of Dettol I added here. Check here what is happening. Okay, here the Dettol is mixing in the water. So to make the process faster, okay, now I will dissolve it. Now you can understand the Dettol liquid is completely dissolved in this water. So where the Dettol molecules went, the spaces between the particles of water, the Dettol molecules went. Means we can understand that in between the particles of matter have some spaces. Okay. So with these two activities we can understand the particles between the particles of matter, intermolecular spaces are present, and diffusion also. Diffusion means the property of a substance mixing on their own. For diffusion in lower classes, one activity you might have done. Okay, one jasmine if you keep in one corner of the classroom, the total entire class you can observe the smell of the jasmine. That is because of diffusion. Diffusion means the property of a substance mixing of the particles on their own. When in case of jasmine, if you keep in the one corner of the room, the smell of the jasmine mixed with the gas. Why? Because in our surrounding gas is there. So the smell of the jasmine is mixed with the gas molecules and diffusion takes place. That's what we can able to get the smell of the jasmine. The diffusion of gases is more.
than the diffusion in liquids than the solids. First thing, the diffusion of gases is more, and the second is diffusion of liquids is they occupy the second position, and the diffusion in solids is very, very less, we can say, right?